networks, going to conferences, forums, to market my blog and tell people about it and just get the word out. I was like just basically telling everyone about my blog. The thing I had to focus on, obviously, as well, aside from the marketing aspect of getting the name out, is, you know, coming up with a, who is my target audience, who are my readers. I had to research, do a bit of research on who was visiting my blog. And in the beginning, it was not very clear to me who exactly was visiting my blog. And then, you know, there are sources like Pt.4, Alexa, gives you, which, and Google obviously gives you a bit more information about the demographics. And once I discovered that, hey, you know, there is a certain pattern here as to the type of people who are visiting my blog, then once I started to identify these audiences, I could target them a lot more as well. And target them a lot more is that's in the marketing, the type of content I publish that is more geared towards that target audience. And brand building was another focus area, which I shall talk about in more detail in the next slide. But it's brand building for me was, what is Velvet Escape about? What does it convey? What is the message that I want to convey via Velvet Escape? And these were things that I had to think about. And once I had the story, how to convey that story to my audience. So it was all a big plan, four focus areas, I'll start with ingredients to build a personal brand. So the first thing that I did when it came to my personal brand was I needed to have a story. So my story is investment banker, 10 years, the whole story, and got into blogging. And, you know, it's a story that's, I think, you know, quite a few people can associate themselves with the story, can relate to that story. It's a story that's appealing. And, you know, it has to be a story that will bring people back to you, will get people interested in your blog and bring them back to your blog day after day or maybe every other day, you know. So it has to be a story. There has to be a story. There has to be a story about the brand. What does the brand stand for? What type of content is it about? So one thing that really helped was doing interviews. I did quite a lot of Twitter interviews. I did interviews on other blogs. I did video interviews, and always told the same story everywhere. So I knew that. I discovered that consistency is key, and that story, once I had that story, it was just basically just telling the same story over and over and over again, slightly different forms, obviously, in case it starts to get boring, but that is basically what I learned, being consistent. And the next thing about the brand was the look and feel of it, of the blog. How does the blog look like, the colors that I want to use, just a general, you know, when you open the blog, you know, what does it look like? Does it, you know, is it cluttered with all sorts of banners and stuff, or does it have a nice clean feel to it? These were things that I looked into as well. A profile picture, yeah, that was one thing I did very early on. I just chose a picture which I thought, hey, that's me. This is what I look like, and I just stuck with that picture, and I've used it everywhere. I put it on Gravatar, so every time I leave a comment on someone else's blog, my picture pops up. It's always the same picture on Twitter, Facebook, stumble upon all the other social media platforms, always the same profile picture, so people can identify with me. And they look at that picture, hey, that's Keith. Keith from Velvet Escape. So that picture is just everywhere. It's taken at Equals to Falls, by the way. And also, one thing that helps to build your brand is the content that you publish on your blog. I think that's very important. It's very important to write about things that you're passionate about, which reflect your personality, because that will be part of your brand. If you're like ranting about something continuously, well, that's your brand. Or if you just love to talk about cruises, well, that's your brand. I like to talk about travel inspiration. That's my brand, which is very broad, I know, but you know, it's a brand. It's my niche. And also another thing that helps to build a personal brand is just by talking to your readers, talking to your audience, talking to your colleagues, your blogger colleagues, and asking them, well, okay, one exercise I did was I created a guest post series called My Velvet Escape Travel Tip. And it was a bit of a branding exercise in the sense that I asked my colleagues to write a guest post for me. And the whole idea was I would ask them, what does the name Velvet Escape mean to you? What does it conjure? And how would you, where would you go, or what would you do in your hometown to get that feeling of a Velvet Escape? So that made people think about my brand